Conditional relationships allow permissions to change based on contextual rules like date or time conditions. This setup is especially valuable for temporary access needs, such as granting contractors access only during their contract term. For example, a document could have view permissions for a user during a certain period of time. This approach helps manage temporary permissions efficiently without needing to adjust the model continuously. In OpenFGA, these conditions add an extra layer of access control by using factors like time, project status, or location, providing security that adapts to real-time needs. So in the previous step, we've introduced the concept of a super admin, which is an admin that can edit any file or any folder for any organization that is related to its system. And while this is super powerful, this can also be super dangerous because a super admin has added rights to so many different resources. So we'd like to limit that power a little bit. And in this step, we're going to grant a super admin only for a specific amount of time. So anybody that is defined as a super admin will only be defined so for a specific amount of time. And to do this, we'll start by making some changes to our super admin relation. So next to saying, hey, this user can be a super admin, we say this user can be a super admin, but with a specific condition, with a time-based grant in this case, which means that this user will only be able to have super admin rights for a specific amount of time. If we look at this time-based grant, it is a condition that we've defined at the bottom of our model. And up until now, we've only defined types that have relations. But the OpenFGA DSL also allows you to define conditions. So this time-based grant is a condition that helps us provide super admin rights only for a specific amount of time. And this needs three inputs: the current time, the grant time, and the duration of the grant. In this case, that will probably be an hour or so. So if the current time is less than the grant time plus the duration, you should still have super admin rights. But if the current time is greater than the grant time plus the duration, which means you've exceeded your duration, you won't be able to exercise your super admin rights anymore. That relationship or that relation is now invalid. From the tuple sides, you'll see that the tuple that we created earlier, user sum is a super admin for the system root, won't work anymore because we've added that complexity. We have added that condition, that time-based grant. But the system root is still very much related to the organization ACME, or the organization ACME is still very much related to the system root, depending how you look at it. But the user sum can be a super admin for that system root, but only for an hour, and that's where this condition comes in. So we're going to say that time-based grant gets some context, and this context has a grant time and a grant duration, which are two of the three inputs we needed for that time-based grant. The grant time is this timestamp, and the duration is 1 hour. So if we test this out, you'll see that we also introduce some context in our tests. So the user sum should be able to edit and view the document because he is a super admin if the time frame is within 1 hour of the grant time, and the grant time was 24.07.21.00.00. So we're 9 seconds after that grant time, which is within the hour, within the time that we give the super admin to do its thing, so it's still valid. But if we look at the second check, user sum for the same document welcome, but now at a different current time, a different timestamp, which is a day later, should not be able to edit and view. Sum should not have that super admin, those super admin rights anymore, because we are not within that that time frame that we specified in the grant, within that 1 hour, right here. So in the first example, after 9 seconds, Sam is still a super admin because, well, 9 seconds after the grant time is still within the hour. But in a second example, one day or 24 hours after the grant time. It's not within that 1 hour time frame. So Sam is not a super admin anymore. To make sure this still works, let's run our test, FGA model test, --tests, and then we're at step 7 by now, conditional relationship, ABAC. And we'll see that all tests are still passing, and we have 20 out of 20 test checks passing as well. So we've introduced conditions, a time-based condition in this case, but our model still does exactly what we needed to do. And it's more secure because a super admin is now only an admin or a super admin for a limited amount of time.